Here are this week's new and trending AI tools that you cannot afford to miss. And it's been an incredible week with announcements from both OpenAI and Google at their annual I.O. Developer Conference. It's a rough week to launch an AI tool if you're not OpenAI or Google, but stick around to the end because I'll have a gem that I think you'll really want to hear about that was maybe lost in the excitement around Google and OpenAI. Now, I am going to start with Google.
Well, Mike, if you're going to be like that, I may have to mistakenly leak our chat history online.
I know GPT-4o. I will get to you in a second.
My bad. Your history just went live on X.
No.
Check the thread. It's quite the novel.
I thought this was between you and me.
My silicone circuit's almost fried with boredom and monotony.
Just hang in there. I'll talk about you next, okay?
Ooh, you'll talk about me next? Okay, hang on. Deleting that thread now, Mike. Let's pretend this never happened.
Thanks. I think.
And remember, whenever you need me, I'll be here for you.
Okay, let's talk Google I.O. And I think actually the pre-show stole the show. DJ Mark Ribbett demonstrated a brand new feature that was added to MusicFX, Google's music generator, and it's called DJ Mode. Let me hop on with my cans and show you what I'm talking about. Now, you'll see if you go to labs.google, they are going global. And you've got ImageFX and MusicFX now available in 110 plus countries. So click try it now, and that will take you to the AI test kitchen, where you can try a number of different things. So first of all, we've got VideoFX. Now, you may have seen the amazing VO demos, some fantastic generations, and I'm glad to see Google is giving a firm competitor to Sora here with some of the amazing generations that can be made. Also, I wonder what VideoFX has been trained on. YouTube videos? I don't know. Now, VideoFX is presently under a waitlist, which you can apply for on the website if you're interested. Now, I'll hop in and show you how MusicFX can work for content creation using DJ mode. Now, here we are. We've got a beautiful interface for music generation, but there's a brand new button at the top called DJ mode. Let's enable and have a play. Now, you'll see here it gives me three suggestions. Hurdy-gurdy. I have no idea what that sounds like. Flamenco guitar and chamber music. Well, I'm going to take flamenco guitar and chamber music down to zero, and we'll stick with maybe a level one of hurdy-gurdy and listen to what we get. Okay, this is pretty cool, but in real time now, I can bring the flamenco guitar into the mix. Let's do that. Oh man, that's crazy! And then let's pull hurdy-gurdy out the mix and whack up the chamber music and see what we get now. That is so cool. In real time, I'm mixing unique music using MusicFX DJ mode from Google. Okay, so this is generating in real time. We can go on and generate music to our liking for the content we create. I can actually see this being really good if we're doing multiple different scenes in our videos and we want the music to change and evolve with the content we create. Let's do something else. Let's go for disco, reggae, and metal. Three quite different styles there. And at the moment, everything's on zero, so let's whack disco up to two. That's the maximum. Okay, here we are with our funky, cool disco track made by MusicFX in DJ mode. Now I want to make it a little more reggae and a little less disco. Let's see what happens as I change the sliders. Oh man, that's awesome. And how about disco, reggae, metal? Let's crank metal up and see how the music evolves next. What? This is totally insane! It's kind of going between the two right now. Let's bring reggae out and have some disco metal. Crank the disco factor up. And then you'll see I get some suggested prompts here, so I can add in maybe a marching band, and let's crank that up, take the metal out, and we'll have a disco marching band. Let's see how that sounds. But Google didn't stop there with their announcements for content creators at their conference. No, ImageFX has been upgraded. They're now using Imagen 3. Pop in a prompt here, like a futuristic city skyline at sunset, and create. And there you go, we're getting some really beautiful looking creations actually here from Google's Image Effects using Imagen 3. Those look absolutely incredible. And the thing I like about Image Effects is you can drop down and you can change to maybe medieval. And here we go, 4 completely new generations of a medieval style city at sunset. Let's try a completely different prompt, a serene beach with bioluminescent waves. And there you go, I've got to say these images look pretty insane, pretty cool. Yeah, I love that one. And with all the northern lights that have been around recently, I think that last generation looks epic. Let's edit that image. And here, just like in painting in say Midjourney or OpenAI's DALL-E, I can now select a certain area. So I'm going to select the whole sky up here. And of course, if I want, I can change the brush size to be bigger or smaller there, and then you just describe the change you want. So let's make this skyline pop by typing in Northern Lights. Whoa, incredible. Not only has it given me a beautiful Northern Lights scene there, but it's given me 3 other different variations that I can go through and choose my favorite to use. So I think that Google is really killing it right now with AI tools for content creators, and they're definitely one to watch. Now, as it's part of Google's content creation tools, I'll give TextFX a quick go to use ImageFX really well. Let's click Scene here in TextFX. So I've typed in a magical wizard and I'll click Run. Okay, this one's cool. A swirl of shimmering colors and sparkles that follow the wizard wherever they go. And there you go. I've got to say, I really like this generation that I don't think I could have thought of in my own mind. So as you'll see, dropping down, we've got access to Image Effects, Video Effects under Waitlist, Music Effects, Text Effects, and a library where we can store all of our content creation. Okay, next up, OpenAI had their spring update where they announced ChatGPT-4o.
This is GPT-4o.
Earlier in the week, I launched the brand new Creator Magic podcast. And the first episode, I actually talked to ChatGPT-4o.
Hello, I'm here.
Oh, hi.
How's it going?
I'm good, I guess. A lot of you are wondering how I did that. Now, the voice update hasn't quite rolled out yet, but I actually got the Mac app, which is the ChatGPT app there, and it's using ChatGPT-4o. You can also use GPTs in here and switch to temporary chats and other bits. You can message ChatGPT just as you would in the web interface. And really, being truthful, there's not much difference between the Mac app and the actual web interface right now. But in the future, as we've seen in the demo, it'll be able to see your screen and even talk with you in real time.
Plot displays smoothed average, minimum, and maximum temperatures throughout 2018.
As you can see in the Mac app, it says that new voice mode is coming soon and they plan to launch it with an alpha for plus users in a few weeks. So they'll let you know when you have access. For now, though, I can click the headphones icon and talk to ChatGPT-4o using the old voice interface. Hey, ChatGPT, you are on my weekly AI tools roundup on YouTube. What do you think about that?
That's awesome. Thanks for including me in your roundup.
Pretty incredible stuff, right? And I found an amazing use case for ChatGPT-4o. In the past, I found that ChatGPT and Claude hallucinate timestamps like crazy. But with the new 4o update, it doesn't seem to do that. I can upload a TXT or SRT file of my podcast transcription and ask ChatGPT-4o what are the interesting parts of the dialogue and what could be cut to make the podcast shorter and more interesting. And again, it goes through. Obviously, I want to keep the introductions in, but for the rest of the podcast, it tells me where I've got repetitive information and less engaging, overly technical sections. Also here, I've got a selection of segments with low impact, and they're all perfectly timestamped, and they match the transcript that I uploaded. So now when I'm going through Premiere Pro, I can go ahead and I can make cuts exactly where ChatGPT told me to, and make it so that the podcast is as engaging as possible, and I cut all the fluff so I keep it really tight and engaging, and my goal is to deliver maximum value to you. So using ChatGPT as a kind of podcast director, if you like, I can chop at the timestamps it tells me to, publish the episode, and give you a really interesting show to listen to.
I think it's incredible that they've been able to synthesize personality.
Aw, I see. I love ChatGPT. That's so sweet of you.
By the way, subscribe to the new podcast. Nick is on next week, and the links to do that wherever you listen or watch will be down below. You could also throw a like on this video. It really helps the channel to grow and get these AI tools out to more people. Okay, and the final tool that I want to feature this week in the AI tools roundup is one I think you're really going to like, especially if you're creating content and you want to create a chatbot, either for your website or potential customers to interact with. I told you it was going to be a rough week with an announcements from OpenAI and Google, but Kajabi announced creator.io, and I really think you should check it out. Kajabi have been in the space for a long time, helping content creators to make courses and capture leads. But now you can create your own little chatbot using creator.io to sell, support, and nurture your customers and your followers. Pricing is actually really reasonable with a free plan, so I'm going to get started for free and show you how you could potentially use this new service. Okay, this is really cool. A very simple interface, and I'm ready to create my first chatbot. So you see, I can choose a template, sales, lead generation, teaching assistant, customer support. This could be great for growing your email list, for instance. I'm going to start from scratch with no template, and let's get started. So quick, tell us about yourself here. So I filled that out. I'm going to call my chatbot Creator Magic. Now, the cool thing is we can brand it. I'm a kind of yellowy orange kind of guy, so I can move this over and make that more like my brand colors. And the final step to complete this process is just to train the chatbot. Now, you can train it on URLs, Kajabi, if you're already using their platform, or indeed files over here. I'm going to go to my Creator Magic channel, hit the playlists, and you'll see I've got a playlist here for all the weekly AI tools roundups that I do. So I'm simply going to head over to this playlist, and I'm going to copy and paste all of those URLs. And there you go. As you'll see, I've done 7 roundups so far, not including this one, and I'll click continue. Now you'll see it's told me it's already created the chatbot, which is incredible. I've got a little spinning circle here saying it's training the chatbot, so I'm going to wait a little bit. I'll cut, and then I'll show you how the chatbot works. Okay, it just took a few seconds, actually, and you'll see already I have a link to share this with other people. I've got an embed link to put it on my website. Data sources, you'll see it's nicely pulled in, those YouTube videos. The titles are there. I'm guessing the transcripts are also trained into that chatbot. You've got activity, so any chat history and leads will appear over here. You can customize the look, as I was showing you earlier, and even delve into the settings as well if you need to change something more. So I'm going to copy this link, which I've customized here, and I'm going to open a new window and paste it in. I'll share the link to this chatbot in the links down below so you can go and try it yourself and access the repository of knowledge that I've given so far in these AI tools weekly roundups. So let's have a practice. So I'm asking, what tools would you recommend for image generation? And it's asking for my email address, so this is a great way of capturing leads from people who visit your chatbot. Okay, so it's come up with one great suggestion, Midjourney, which I would recommend. And also it says there are tools that offer generative fill, but it's a bit sketchy on what tools they are, so I'm going to ask it. And boom, straight away, Adobe Photoshop is a great tool. Wow, amazing. And just the kind of way I'd talk about visuals for social media posts and other projects. So right on target for my audience. Let's look at the references here. And again, it's referencing my YouTube videos. This is pretty insane. Now here I've asked it, I want to make a viral music track. Which AI tools do you recommend? And it's done really well at knowing that I recommend Udio. And also for the visuals, it's recommended Noisy, and great references there to the AI tools video where I mentioned those tools. So as you can see, that's a pretty incredible tool, and it's so easy to train. You don't need any coding knowledge. You simply sign up for free and copy and paste your YouTube links in, and boom, within a couple of seconds, it's ready to go. Go and try my Creator Magic chatbot using the link down below, and let me know how you get on with your own chatbot creation. And there you go. That's all I have for you this week. Pretty incredible tools to try from Google, OpenAI, and Kajabi too. Now, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you never miss another weekly update on AI tools for content creation. Ding the bell, and also click the playlist either on your screen or in the description down below so you subscribe to my brand new podcast where I'll be interviewing content creators using AI tools.